My name is Todd Brickstead. I grew up in Eskel, Minnesota. I teach in Hermantown currently. I have a story for you. My father and brother, who's a couple years older than me, decided to go out to our hunting shack in the wintertime on snowmobiles, and they spent the night at our shack. Well, the next day they were thinking about some of the neighbors that we have, and they decided to go run to some of the other cabins, and they approached one of the cabins, and there was two snowmobiles outside, and they did not like the look of the area, and they definitely didn't like the feel. And he went up to the doorway, and when he did, as he opened the doorway, there was a youngster there, probably in his 14 to 16 year old, and he was dead. We assumed that it was carbon monoxide poisoning. They had a stove in their house, and they also had lanterns that they used. And I think maybe they just didn't shut them off, and so the fuel leaked. As you know, most cabins aren't made very secure or very airtight, and so they sat in that probably all night long and didn't make it when their bodies sensed that there was a problem. Because it's a colorless, odorless gas, you don't know that it's the silent killer. You don't know it's sneaking up on you. If at all possible, if they have a detector that they can put in there with them. Some people have generators, some don't, if you have that electrical ability. Number two is to be careful. And again, like I said, triple checking. I'm 58 years old and we haven't had a problem yet because we're very cognizant of it.